I spent all day Saturday sitting in my recliner watching college basketball on one channel, the golf tournament on another, and sometimes both at the same time. I'm sitting in a chair, drinking a Diet Coke, watching games on TV, while hundreds of thousands of young people are marching for their lives. I used to be those kids. And it bothers me a great deal that I'm not anymore. I used to think that my generation could change the world, and in some ways we did, but not nearly the way we thought we would. I'm not taking a side tonight, although I know you think I am. I'm just hoping the kids from Parkland don't lose the passion they have now, the passion that I had at 18, until I allowed life to get in the way. The survivors of that latest school shooting have mobilized America, and part of the world, too. And maybe this time it will be different. The cynic in me doesn't think so, because the people they're trying to reach don't work for you and me. They never have. They work for their biggest donor. They work for a check. And the money always wins. It's one of the reasons why I haven't voted since 1972. I didn't want to vote for the lesser of two evils. I wanted to vote for the perfect candidate. And the reality is there isn't one. Here's another reality. When you choose not to vote for the lesser of two evils, sometimes the bigger evil wins. Evil in the form of a former U.S. senator, a man like Rick Santorum, who ran for president of the United States and says these kids who were marching Saturday should be learning CPR instead. His answer to the gun violence in America is to learn CPR. I'm going to stop for a moment and just let the incredible ignorance of that statement sink in. One of my favorite TV characters, Boston Legal's Alan Shore, said once, "The real joy of life lies in the promises of tomorrow." And while I probably don't have many tomorrows, the 17 killed in Parkland don't have any. The 26 killed at Sandy Hook don't either, nor do the 13 killed in Columbine. The kids at Marjory Stoneman Douglas say their fight isn't over. This is just the start. Disagree with their cause if you must. We can't even agree anymore on what a school shooting is. But how can you not respect the passion and commitment of an Emma Gonzalez, a David Hogue, and all the kids at Parkland who are only trying to make a better America? Because that's what a lot of us did until we allowed life to get in the way.